your body is self-regulating, self-healing.
Absolutely. And then that's when that kind of came around, right? This doing all this research up until that point. And then after that, hearing doctors that were open-minded talk about, well, why can't your body just heal itself? All of that was like, to me, it was like, oh, duh. Yeah. Like, why wouldn't our bodies? But I was already coming to that because even in like when I was dating that guy that I dated for like 8 years, when I was dating him, he and I would look into like health topics and stuff like that. We'd share all that stuff with each other. And there was this guy that we were watching for a while named Dr. Jason Fung. And he was talking about how I think he would talk about fasting and things like that. Yeah. Right. And one of the quotes I always remember him saying was like, your body isn't stupid. Like, don't treat your body like it's stupid. It knows what it's doing. So that kind of got my mind going like, yeah, no shit. The body isn't retarded. Like if it's giving you a signal, if there's a reason for it, if you're vomiting or whatever, like there's a reason. Something happened and you're being told, okay, watch it. What did you do? What triggered that? You know, it's for you to heal yourself.
I'm sorry. I was talking with a gal named Nikki Bennett. She's a nutritionist and she was talking about food as a language. I thought this was brilliant. What? Your body gets food and it speaks a language to your cells. And if it's real food, nutritional food, it your helps body your body.
Understands it.
It understands what it's supposed to do with holy the food. Shit. But when you eat stuff that's crap and just not really food, it's edible poison, usually, your body doesn't know what to do with it because it can't read the chemical. It can't read the language. So it just stores it in your fat cells, destroys your liver.
Oh, wow.
Gives you cancer. Your body just doesn't know what to do with this stuff that you're putting in there because it doesn't understand the language.
Oh my God. That's a really good metaphor. And it makes a lot of sense. I like that.
So brilliant.
Who said that?
Nikki Bennett. I'll get you the link to her radio show. She does. It's, I can't remember the name.
That's
of
okay.
Her
that's
show,
okay. I just wondered, I sometimes like to know the source of some content.
Yeah, she's been in the nutrition field for many years, and that was just one of those quotes. It's like, yeah, that just makes it all make so much sense.
Yeah, definitely, for sure. Just
asking yourself, can my body read this? Is it going to understand what I'm trying to tell it to do with this food?
Mm-hmm. I love that. And the other thing too is, and Brandon and I probably have talked about this in a previous show, but also like where you're at spiritually too, you know, because if there's still things that you need to learn spiritually, your body's just going to have to use itself to warn you, to remind you, to like tell you, wake you up for something. So, you know, there are people who could probably eat, you know, something that would harm someone else, but it wouldn't harm them. Like, it's kind of like reminds me of that Bible scripture where you shall take up snakes and they won't hurt you, or you'll like eat poison and it won't hurt you. It's like that, because if you're at a place spiritually, elevated that spiritually, it's not going to affect you. But that's not to say that you're better than someone else. It's just that that's where you are spiritually.
Have you heard of Eritarians?
Oh, breatharians. Yeah. We talked about that a lot on the show before. Yeah. It's, you know, it's possible, right? You know, I'm not going to say that you can do that forever for the rest of your life unless you're like some like yogi or like some kind of like master at something, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And that's like you dedicate your life to that or whatever. But I think it is possible to do, you know? I mean, what is fasting? It's like, you can fast. Jesus did it 40 days, you know, literal fast. It's not impossible. But also you have to be spiritually capable of those things too. You shouldn't just go into it willy-nilly and just like, oh, I'm going to fast, because that's not what your body may be asking for, you know?
Yeah. And that's a really good point. People need to be able to be more in tune with their body and listen to what their intuition is telling them. Religion tries to train us to listen to what somebody else tells us, and that somebody else is going to be responsible for whatever things happen, you know, just confess your sins and move on.
Mm.
Well, no, figure out why that happened and don't do that shit again. Don't feel guilty about it, because guilt's just going to make you sick, honestly.
Mm.
But just, you know, if it's not serving your higher good, don't do it. And if it's not serving the higher good of the people in your community, probably shouldn't do that either. But it's just listening to your body and staying in tune with it. You know,